And I welcome Professor Schwieder from Civil Department of Engineering, GIT, Belgaum, for this particular career guidance session. I hope that this session would be beneficial for all the participants, because we are here today to guide the students to take the right decision for their future.
Next,
not much time of yours, so I leave it to you. You can please take it over. I'll meet you the presenter now.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, sir, you can start.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. I am Dr. R. Sridhar, HOD of Civil Engineering Department. I would like to present the profile of Civil Engineering Department. Before that, I would like to present Locus's video. Thank you, Lopez, sir. Next. Next slide.
I guess there is sound is not coming, madam.
We are able to hear.
Sir, no, the video is not audible. I can listen to you, but not the video.
Is there any other option, like we can...
Is it playing normally here?
I'll just check it.
No problem. Start it.
Just now audible.
Okay.
Please raise the volume. It's not audible.
Sir. All audible in London.
Dear participants, we regret for the technical inconvenience. We are not able to hear the video. Listen to the audio of this particular video. So please give us some time. We are rectifying the error.
Hello, ma'am. I'm audible. Hello, ma'am.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Okay, and then I will start my presentation. I think there is some problem with
Yes, please. Yes.
Yeah. Welcome all the participants, my dear students and their parents. This is Dr. R. Sridhar, HOD of Civil Engineering Department. I'd like to present you the civil engineering profile. Now, why civil engineering? You know that the infrastructure development is a measure of a nation's progress, which is a manifestation of oldest and the core engineering discipline. So that's why it's now that's where the civil engineering is the mother of all engineering branches. And I think you know that it is the second oldest engineering discipline after military engineering. Have you heard of Sir M. Visheshwaraya, an excellent statesman and eminent civil engineer? So we are always proud that yes, Sir M. Visheshwaraya is India's greatest civil engineer. Okay, now coming to the civil engineering, which is we started in the year 1979-80 with the intake of 45, then we've increased to 60, and now right now we have 120 that was sanctioned in 2014. You know that the principal had told you that our college is NBA accredited. Our civil engineering department is 4 times NBA accredited. So that means NBA accredited, it means that our education is in par with the global standards. So we got the 4th time accreditation in the year 2018 and goes up to 2021. And you also know that we run structural engineering courses, that is in M.Tech in structural engineering, with an intake of 18 now. And it is the most sought after the branch in this part of the Karnataka, and also the students do come from all over Karnataka. And it is also accredited now from 2017 up to 2020, and we are going for the next accreditation process in the next year. And we also run a research center which is where we offer PhD for the scholars so that they can complete their PhD degree. And also you know that the institution is accredited by NAC for 5 years with A+ grade. So what is civil engineering? Various branches of civil engineering we have. We start with structural engineering. So that's what you study: water resources engineering, environmental engineering, construction management, transportation engineering, and geotechnical engineering. So when we have designed the syllabus to cater to these specific branches of civil engineering, where what do you do in structural engineering? In structural engineering, you know that we have a lot of multi-story buildings. We analyze, we design, plan, analyze and design such buildings. And not only buildings, we also take care of bridges, for roads, like this. And when you come to geotechnical engineering, whatever the related to the soil, so your building has to rest on the soil. So what is the strength of the soil? We try to investigate the properties of the soil and see that your buildings are safe, your bridges are safe, like that. You have seen the dams, you have seen many hydraulic structures in and around where we have seen Hidkal Dam or any other super dam like this. So that comes as a part of the water resources engineering. So we have what is known as transportation engineering, where you study about the railways, the highways, like this. So that means you have to design. It has to be designed. These roads have to be designed for a particular load. So that's why we take care of this maintenance, evaluations, and design of this highway in particularly in the case of transportation engineering. And in case of environmental engineering is a very important facet of civil engineering, because the water that you drink or the sanitation that you have is taken care of environmental engineering. So we have water treatment plants, we have sanitations where we have to design proper treatment plants for the safe use. And regarding the construction management, what does construction management is all about? So you have to manage the resources, you have to manage the people, you have to manage the cash flow, you have to manage the materials. So these are all will be taught in the construction management, where you can play a role of a managerial here, and so that you can better utilize these resources in the construction projects. So what when you, we should take up civil engineering, so what and then what is the skill that you require to succeed? So you should have a technical perfection, because your analytical skills becomes very important. So whatever you draw on the paper, you have to reproduce that in the site. So you should have a very good communications with everybody. You should manage the site, so therefore you should have a project management skills, a creativity. So how the load transfer takes place, and how you have to see that some creativity is done in each of the projects, so then you would have a better visualization of what the projects that you do, and you should have a very very critical thinking of the future projects, and also you should try to design the structures such that it should withstand for a longer period. So we in the civil department, we follow outcome based education. So that is which follows because we are accredited, that should be for the global standards. So therefore we give more on the project based learning in our curriculum. So that's why we have some course seminars where students have to do some course projects that they have to do in all the subjects in each of the semesters. And here, because a lot of MNC companies, like we have SNC Levelin or maybe Atkins, these companies are there where students are sent for internships so that they are better prepared for such postings in such MNC companies. And also we have some industry driven honor courses, because we have honors in construction management, and also we offer industry driven regular courses where the students are also sent to the industry where they can do their project work and come back to our institute. So, and also we run some certification courses so that we are better equipped with some technical skills, and also the students are motivated to take up the courses that are offered from IITs, like we have what is known as NPTEL certification courses. And in the department, we run the training programs where we have faculty development programs or webinars or invited guest lectures on various industry-related topics, which are conducted on a regular basis. With the salient features of the department is we have a very well qualified faculty members. We have 8 PhD holders. All faculties are an expertise in their domain of civil engineering. That's I told you, the various domains of civil engineering. We have faculty in almost all the domains of civil engineering. We have a specialized training in the domain of structural engineering, because we run PG courses in structural engineering. And we are also associated with very professionally known bodies like Institute of Engineers and National Highway Authority. Authorities, particularly in civil engineering. And so to hone the skills of our students in particular technical events and fest, we run what is known as an avalanche program or a paradox, which is a national technical fest where all the events are managed by the students and supported by the staff. So as I said, that we are proud to say that the total number of faculty members are on 30, and we have PhD holders are 8, number of professors are 5, number of associate professors are 3, and total assistant professors are 22. So this retention rate is very good. So the average age of the faculty is around 35 years. So that means that in our department, we have a faculty with a very rich experience in their particular domain, and the average teaching experience comes to about 9 years. So I have put up over 30, 31 years of service. Like that, all the 5 professors have put more than 30 years of services, and we have the young professors also. So that's how the average teaching experience in this college comes to about 9 years in civil department. So this is my strength. So I, Sridhar, I'm a professor. Like this, Vinod Dosur is a professor. We have 5 professors which I've named here, and also a young brigade where Vaibhav Chate, Vikas Gingine, and Nitendra Panka, they are associate professors. So like this, we have the assistant professors. I'm very proud of them because they are proactively involved in all the departmental works and also in the teaching curriculum. So this is the other assistant professors that we have. So that means we have a full-fledged faculty in our department. I'm proud to say that civil engineering department has got a lot of consultancy projects that are going on in and around Belgaum. So we do a lot of third-party inspections for various infrastructure development companies like Karnataka Rural Infrastructure Development. We are also involved in smart city projects, and also we are in involved in various industries like Hindalco. So this consultancy is going on and going on for many years, and we have expertise in almost all domains so that we can offer consultancy projects. To cater to these consultancy projects and to the curriculum, we have well-established laboratory, which is a structural engineering laboratory. So you can see the two pics of structural engineering laboratory, where we have what is known as a loading frame and a C frame, which no other colleges have in this part of Karnataka and very few colleges in Bangalore. So that this can be used for research as well as for M.Tech students. So that we have a very full-fledged laboratory which is established, and that's why our PG courses is in a greater demand. We also have a separate computer laboratories. We have concrete laboratory. We have geotechnical laboratory. Like this, we have a modernized environmental laboratory. We also cater to nanotechnology also in this environmental laboratory. We do a lot of testings for various industries in the material testing laboratory. And we have high-end equipments like total stations, which are used for survey, which also serves for consultancy purposes also. And also we have an hydraulics laboratory. So what are the key areas of research that you can find? So we especially deal with earthquake engineering, and also we design a lot of bridges in and around in Karnataka. And also we have, you can see many steel structures which are designed by civil department here. And we have a separate cell for geotechnical engineering. We do a lot of soil testing for the many projects in and around Belagam. And also we have key areas in concrete technology as well as in construction materials. And we have a special cell for structural analysis and designs. We do a lot of analysis and designs of multi-story buildings in our department. So here in this particular cases also we are more involved in concrete mix design, well, structure design and drafting, soil testing, and we also do like water and wastewater analysis, and also in surveying. So these are our strength of the departments, which are actively involved in most of the projects that are involved in and around Belagam. I'm proud to say that we have the memorandum of understanding with Synergy School of Business Skills, that we always deal with skill development programs for the students in construction project management. So that's why we have offered many courses through the Synergy School of Business Skills. And also we have, in order to carry out the social activities, also to carry out some eco-friendly sustainable construction projects, we have an MOU with Gokuldham, which is a unit of ISKCON. And we have an MOU with the Balekundri Memorial Trust. We conduct Balekundri Memorial activities. And also we have recently we signed an MOU with National Highway Authority of India, so to promote research activities and internships for students. So this is for 5 years, and our students can do internships. So if you join as a civil, as a, in our department and do civil engineering, so you will have an you can get associated with National Highway Authority of India, and you can do internship. You will be paid around 10,000 rupees, and even PG students are paid about 20,000 rupees. And we have adopted two stretches of highway, which is, you can see Belagam to Khanapur is adopted by our civil department, and also from Khanapur to Goa. So now these will be maintained by the civil department, and a lot of research activities will go on for another 5 years in our department. We also offer certification courses to enhance the skills. Like we are the nodal center for Indian Institute of Remote Sensing, which will offer satellite photogrammetry and its applications. And we offer many certification courses, in particular in construction management. We offer courses. Students can do courses from Coursera and also from NPTEL, from IITs, for any of the IITs. We also have a tie-up with the Pune company, where the latest softwares will be, the students will be given training for about 50 hours, and they can take some live project using this software. So this is the kind of the support that we are giving from civil engineering department. not only like certification courses, we also have some FTPs which are organized, and the resource persons are particularly that who have visited our civil department is the Dodgodar sir, who is a professor of IIT Madras, Shiv Kumar Babu is a professor from Indian Institute of Science Bangalore, Shridip is a professor from IIT Guwahati, there are a few scientists who are coming from National Institute of Hydrology, we have Lalit Borana who is from IIT Indore, and Abhishek is also from IIT. They have visited our department. They have given lectures to the students. They have given lectures in our faculty development programs also. We also have an institution of engineers students chapter where students are exposed to the organizing the engineering events, like we have poster presentations or stick structures like this. You can make a model. We can have a quiz events like this. So this is what the kind of exposures that we give in the civil department. And also we have various other competitions like model making or a logo making like this. And also we take the students to various field like for a dam sites or industrial projects, like I have shown some pics of that. And we have some guest lectures which are organized throughout the year. We have what is known as a design thinking workshop for our students. We give some idea about what the projects they can do, and they have to think and bring out some design and then convert into a prototype. So that is what we try to hone the skills like and or think make them to think about some projects, and if the projects comes out very good, then we can they can go ahead for the patenting or something like that. So that's why that is what we are trying to develop their entrepreneurship skills in them. So that's why civil department is very, very actively involved in design thinking workshop that we have conducted for 2-3 times in the last few years. And this is the today at 11 o'clock I opened a design competition for the students where we have a basketball court which you see here, and then that can be converted to an indoor stadium. So that is how the opportunities that we give to the students, and we have announced a cash prize for that also, so that students can come out and exhibit their talent so that they can come out with the designs, and that will be turned into reality in our campus. So that's the kind of exposures that we give to the students. And we have the National Technical Fest, the pics of the National Technical Fest, which is known as a paradox, that we conduct every year. So that is the national level technical fest where a lot of competitions will be arranged, and the students will do participate, and from all other they have interactions with other students who come from various parts of Karnataka. And not only the academic, we also involve the students in social activities. You can see that we have an MOU with Gokuldham. We take the students to Gokuldham, a unit of ISKCON. They do various social activities, and so they will learn about the social ethics in real life. So that is what we try to expose them. So we have participated in various social responsibility like Swachh Bharat, like work in Swachhata work in ashrama, or raising mud blocks to grow vegetables, or we do survey for laying water pipelines. Our girl students have arranged many library books in the ashram, and how to stack them in proper places so that the inmates can use them properly. We have done whitewashing of the walls like this. See, these are the social activities that we expose to the students also. And so during this COVID time, we told our students to participate in webinars that we organized in our department. So therefore, we have series of webinars that we have organized, about 14-15 webinars we have organized. So our students are very good in they go to a very good institute like NICMAR, or maybe even to the foreign universities, which I have shown here. They go for higher studies. The NICMAR is a very good where our students are taking admissions there. Even they have gone to UK, they have gone to Canada, they have gone to Australia, and there are some of the students who have gone to very prestigious universities or institutes in India. And our placements are very good. Like, that is the highlights. We have placed our students in PwC, Afghans, SNC Lovelin, that is Atkins, in JW Consultants. DCP is an MNC company. Zamel Steel is an MNC company. Again, ACC Concrete. So where the lowest salary ranges from 2.5 lakhs to, we have higher salary about 4 lakhs. So that's what we have seen. That's the picks of that we, our students who are placed. So we have a lot of placements activities that are going on. It has seen an exponential rise in past 3 years. And you can see the placements that we have done through our placement cell. These are some few more picks of our students who are placed in a prestigious companies definitely when a student takes here, he will have a lot of opportunities. I'm very proud to say that Ahad Tharade, who bagged 13 gold medals and secured 93.84. So this is a record in the VTU, which he has secured or bagged about 13 gold medals. So then he did his NICMAR course, and now he's a reputed engineer. And our student Ankit Chelle went to a Indian Republic parade, and he's also a part of Indian youth delegation to China. And I'm very happy of this Anmol, who got the best student chapter for the Karnataka from the IST. And now she's in Japan to do her, she's completing her project work in Shibura Institute of Technology. So the civil department also motivates the students to go abroad to do their project work. And also, I'm proud to say that my students are qualified in GATE exam before they can take admissions in IITs. Now, Bahubali, who has secured 51 marks out of very good marks, so that he will definitely get in IITs. Now we have few VTU blues in hockey and aquatics, where Rutuja Power, who was represented in lovely professional university, and she has bagged many the medals in the competitions. And Rutraj Desai and his partners have also participated in IIT Mumbai, and they won the prize. It is an all India level competitions where they have got a cash prize of 25,000 and won the prize there. And they won second prize competing with all IIT students. So that's the exposures that we give in our civil department. Have a prestigious alumni like Jack Beston, is a CEO in Wire Group. Vinay Behar is a senior structural engineer. Dilip Kulkarni is a senior structural engineering. Ashwini Valsang is in PwC, which is Abhishek is in Dubai. Lalit Purana is a faculty in IIT. They're all passed out from our college, and Shanti is in Equinox Realty Bangalore. So this is just a glimpse of this. We have a lot of alumni who are in the very prestigious positions. What is the future then? Now, the construction in India is a very fast growing and expanding market. So India is expected to be the third largest construction market globally by 2030. So we can this contribution to the Indian GDP may reach about 15% by 2030. We are largest employer in India by 2022. We are expected to employ more than 75 million people. So that's the scope of civil engineering now. You have particularly, which is Indian construction company will definitely in boom. Very career prospects when you post civil engineering. After you complete your civil engineering from our institute, you can start a job. If you want to start a job, you can start a job in a government sector. You can start a job in a public sector. Therefore, that we should qualify in GATE examinations, and you can aspire for engineering service exams, or you can work in a construction firms. And if you want to go for a higher education, you can do your MBA or you can do your MS in any branch of civil engineering, or you can do your M.Tech in structures or water resources, or you can start. This is one thing is in civil engineering, you can have your own firm, you can be in a contractor, you can be in a consultant. So that is the entrepreneurship that you can start. That is the career options post civil engineering. So avenues are in the field job. You know that field job can be a private sector, can be a public sector, can be a government sectors like this, like PWD. And you can do a research maybe, and you can go for M.Tech and then do a PhD. You can be a scientist in ISRO, BARC or DRDO. Or you can take up a teaching positions after you do your M.Tech. Or you can take a management like in NICMAR, where you can pursue your postgraduate diploma in management. Or you can go for Royal Institute of Chartered Society, where the MBA in management is offered. like this, you can do MBA in operations or PhD DM in marketing, or you can take up entrepreneurship where you can start your own consultancy after completing your BA in civil engineering. You can take up government contracts or private contracts, or then you can start your own contracting firm so that you can take a lot of work. But this is what I wanted to say about the civil engineering. Hope this would give a very good insight on civil engineering and what we do in our department and how we motivate our students. Thank you very much for listening to me. And if you have any questions, you can always ask me. I will be able to answer you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sridhar sir, for the wonderful insight that you have given on civil engineering.
Thank you.
Before we even conclude or go to the question and answer session, I would just like to play the video of our principal, Professor Jayant Kittu sir of the IIT.
Okay.
And with me till I play the video.
Good morning and welcome you all to this webinar series hosted by the KLS Academy. Okay, congratulations to all the participants who have completed successfully their PVC2 exams as well as the CET exams during this challenging time of COVID-19 pandemic. I hope our online mock CET test that we conducted and also the CET Mitra YouTube channel have come handy for you in preparing and following your CET exams. Our Karnataka Law Society, which was established in 1939, is running many courses right from UG to PG, and Bhogte Institute of Technology was established in 1979. From 1979 to 2020, in these 40 years, we have moved a lot. Started with the just four basic branches of civil engineering, mechanical, electrical, and electronics engineering. Today, GIT offers 8 UG courses and 9 PG courses. And we have research centers for awarding the PhD degree under the BU. The Bhogte Institute of Technology has got approval and recognition from the UGC, AICTE, and we are permanently affiliated to VTU. And also, our architecture department is approved by the Council of Architecture. Our quality of education is certified by the national level of quality certifying agencies like the National Board of Accreditation, and we are happy to inform you that our GIT has got an A+ grade by the NAC, and also in the recently conducted NIRF ranking of the 2020, GIT found a place in the rank 201 to 250. The GIT is, as you know, is an autonomous institute under the VTU. So this autonomy has given us a degree of freedom in framing and revising our course content as per the needs of the industry and ever-changing technology. And also, we have adopted new methods of course delivery. The old method of chalk and talk is being replaced gradually or blended with many other course of teaching learning process. And with autonomy, we have established a fair, credible, and transparent examination system. So this autonomy has given us the freedom that we can set our own syllabus, can teach the way that we want, and then we can also conduct the examinations as per the requirements. And finally, we send the list to the university to award the degree. So as far as degree is concerned, it is awarded to the university, but all the process, the authority is given to the college. That is what is the meaning of academic autonomy. We have extensively used this academic autonomy that is conferred on us based on our credibility of 40 years of existence. We have come out with the outcome-based education system, choice-based education system with the different teaching learning process like the project-based learning, blended learning, triple classes, or inquiry-based learning, case of the lab and laboratory exercises. We have introduced a variety of activities like the internships, be it industry internships or the research internship. We have made it compulsory for all the students to attend internships. Then we have introduced certification courses. At least the students have to do two certification courses. It may be online certification, maybe given by the industries, or it can be even given by the NPTEL like academies. And we have introduced the open elective courses so that the students of one branch can understand, or one field can understand, the subjects of the other field. So that is the other beauty of our autonomous syllabus content that we have. And almost every course, we have introduced course projects and course seminars. So this will give a clear understanding of the subject and its implementation into the practical realities. And of course, in the final year, the students will have one full semester to do the project, be it an industry project or on-campus research projects. Even the students can go and do the projects under some industries or leading IITs and NITs, and even we have allowed our students to go abroad and register for the final year projects under some universities abroad and complete the projects. That is the beauty that what we can offer as an autonomous institute. We have received more than 3 crores of grants from the AICT, UGC, ICTU, PTU, like various agencies, so that we can establish laboratories and center of excellences. So we have established various center of excellences wherein the students can carry out certain projects, research, and come out with the different products and all these things. Of course, we have done many MOUs with the foreign universities. As I said, for the student exchange programs, Stanford University, our students regularly every year they go spend more than 1 year, 1 month in Stanford on the design thinking processes. Or they go to the Shibuya Institute of Technology, Japan, or carrying out their final year projects. Similarly, New Plaza or any other universities abroad. Of course, we have got the industry partners to deliver the curriculum along with the industries, be it HAL, Tata Technologies, Quest, CII, ARAI, IBM, Texas Instruments, right? So many industries, local as well as the big industries, we have association and MOUs wherein we are working very closely with the industries. Even recently we have signed a MOU with the National Highway Authority of India, wherein the National Highway Authority of India has given us the stretch of road from Belgaum to Goa, wherein our students will be taking part in the road construction as the interns or the course projects, and also in preparing the project reports and all such kind of activities our students can participate in the nation building activities. Not only that, we facilitate our students to go for higher education, wherein we have tied up with the various professional agencies like the Visotech or the Gate Academy, or we prepare our students for the CAT exams, GRE exams, GATE exams with the help of the Visotech life of a professional training institutes, so that our students can take up for the post-graduation in a very confident way. Also, we encourage our students to take up the entrepreneurship, wherein the design thinking or the concept and idea presentations, we conduct various hackathons, ideathons, so that the students will get geared up for these kind of capabilities. And also, we have facilitated our students for entrepreneurship in terms of establishing the incubation center, wherein the different incubators can work, and also innovation center that we have established. And idea cell is there to help you get the various patents registered. And on our campus, there are many startups which are existing on our campus. Not only the academics, the student has to develop overall in holistic growth. So we have established more than 10-15 student chapters or the clubs, like the ASME, AIEEE, NSS, NASA Association, or the Rotaract Club, or Computer Society of India, ISTE, ACM, Shaurya Club, ISHRAE, right, ISA, like many Fluid Power Society of India. So these student clubs and the chapters will help the students to come out and demonstrate their managerial capabilities, teamwork, communication, idea presentation, all such kind of capabilities will be developed by the students by actively participating in these chapters. So we provide all these platforms. Now it is dependent on the students how well they can make use of these facilities to prune their personalities. Of course, along with the teaching learning processes and co-curricular activities, we also conduct our tech fest called Avalanche. Right from 2001 onwards, we are every year we are conducting where the students will be exposed to the various technical skills, paper presentations at different contexts that we conduct, and also Tech Fest or Cultural Fest Aura, very famous in Belgaum, wherein every year some artists will be coming and demonstrating their capability, and also our students will be taking part in various cultural activities. We have got excellent infrastructure as far as IT is concerned. More than 11 instructions are there with high speed internet, and our various laboratories are there with the latest software needed in the industry, so that our students will be never falling behind as far as the technology is concerned. Library is the temple of excellent facility with the 1.1 lakh of volumes, with the 26,000 journals, titles, and more than 5,000 journals of the national, international, and books. Around 20,000 e-books are available, and we have subscribed to many journals also, and we have developed the smart reading zone wherein they can, students can read using their laptops or with the mobiles. So these are the mobile apps that our students have developed so that they can work closely with the library facilities. Of course, the good infrastructure needs the generator backup or the Xeroxing or even the gym that we provide, so that the overall physical strength is to be improved of the students, and also sports facilities that we provide. College has got a fleet of more than 15-20 buses flying across the city, and also we have got an ambulance, and bus service is given to all the students, no matter whether they are staying nearby or far off distances. And we have got good hostels for the girls and the boys at various locations, be it in the campus also and also in the Bhagyanagar and other places. We have got a good health center wherein the health of the every student, especially in this pandemic situation, taking care of the health of everybody is at most necessity. And we have got a health center with the staff nurse as well as the doctor for the 24 hours service. And of course, we have got a good eateries and canteen facilities. Our students have excelled in the sports in various state level, zonal level, interzonal level, national level, various sports. They have become blues. These are some of the glimpses of our students participating in the sports activities. They have got a dedicated sports center wherein a lot of exercises, yoga, and all those things. And we have got the faculty, two faculties, one male and female faculty for physical directors for helping the students to develop their physical personalities. Now, coming to the admission process at GIT, for the undergraduate level, qualifying examination of a PUC 2 or a class 12 is necessary with at least 45% of marks. Then the student should have appeared KCET or COMEDK to get the admission through that KCET and COMEDK. They can directly get admitted. Or otherwise, even we have got a management quota where if your performance in the PUC or in the KCET and COMEDK is not that good enough, so that your ranking, you may not get a college, then you can come through the management quota. We are open for that admissions also. And of course, for the diploma holders, you can come through the lateral entry to the directly second year through the writing the diploma CET exam and getting the ranking and opting our college. Or otherwise, even we can help you in getting these admissions in the lateral entries. Similarly, for the postgraduate courses that we are offering, whether it is MBA or MCA or MTechs, one has to appear the PGCET and get a ranking and take the choice of our college and get admitted. And if your ranking is not sufficient to get admitted to our college, you can even book your seat through the management quota. That facility is also available in the postgraduate courses. We offer a good scholarship for the meritorious students because we honor the merit. In case of the UG programs, if your CET ranking is less than 1,500, full tuition fee waiver is there. And if your ranking is between 1,500 and 1,000, then 50% tuition fee is waived. And if your ranking is up to 2,500, then 25% of the tuition fee will be waived. And even in the PGCET for the MTech or MBA or MCA, 25% concession fee is given based on your CET percentages or your rankings. Even in for our architectural course, we offer the discounts or the, say, the fee waivers depicted in this particular ranges. And this is, we also conduct every year the toppers felicitation function, wherein the toppers to the university or toppers to the college are given lot of scholarship every year. That is another added feature of our appreciation to the meritorious students. I am leaving you with the glimpses of the third graduation day that was conducted in August. You can see the, our vice chancellor of the PTU and also the TCS representative delivering the special lecture on that day. Now, further, the departmental head of the departments will take care of the further presentation.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, now I hope we'll start with.
Hello.
Yes, even before we take up the question answers, there is a small video which is presented by our Learning Council Chairman, Sri Vinayak Lokurza. So I would like to play this as an introduction to what is PLS Academy about. So please be with me till I play the video.
I am a member of the Karnataka Law Society and the Council Chairman of the PLS Academy. I welcome you to this session. I am the Karnataka Law Society was established in 1939, and today we have institutions ranging from PG to PG in different facets of education. PLS Academy is a branch of the Karnataka Law Society, wherein we bring in those facets of education to make the holistic personality development, which ranges from career guidance to mental counseling. I once again welcome you to this session and thank you for your participation. I am sure you are going to enjoy the learning. Kindly pass on the message to your friends and relatives so that they too can stay benefited by the programs offered by PLS Academy. Thank you once again.
Yes, I thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Is there any... Hello?
Yeah, now we are open for the question and answer session.
Yeah, okay.
I don't see any questions been posted by the participants.
No. No questions are there.
Yes.
Yeah.
So,
anyway, we can give them this one videos, and later on they can contact us for any clarification. We are always there to answer their queries.
Yes. Participants, please post your questions anytime on the respective mail ID, or you can directly call it the respective institutions. We would be anytime happy to answer your query. And on behalf of KLS Academy, I would like to thank Professor Sridhar sir for giving such a wonderful insight on the career opportunities for civil engineering stream. I hope it will have benefited the respective participants who are interested in making the right option, taking the right career option for their life. So thank you, sir, for being with us today.
Thank you. Thank you very much for giving us the opportunity. And it's a very good initiation from KLS Academy that I could highlight about the civil engineering in this platform. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
This conference is no longer being recorded.
Good luck.